Hello everyone, in this video let's study about the different types of anther based on the number of lobes of anther and the type of fixation of the filament to the anther along with the internal structure of anther. Let's study about anther. We know that stamen is the male reproductive structure of a flower. The stamen consists of two important structures. One is the anther, which is lobe-like structure. The other one is a thread-like structure, which is filamentous, and it is called as filament. The proximal end of the filament is attached to the thalamus, and the distal end of the filament is attached to the lobe, that is called as the anther. Based on the number of lobes, we have two types of anther. One, monothecous anther. The second one is dithecous anther. Monothecous anther consists of a single lobe, which is mainly seen in Malvaceae family, for example in hibiscus. Dithecous anthers consist of two lobes and each lobe consists of two pollen sacs. So in monothecous anther we have only two pollen sacs, whereas in dithecous anther totally we have four pollen sacs. There is a sterile tissue which connects the two lobes of the anther, and this sterile tissue is called as connective. Based on the fixation of the filament to the anther, there are different types of anther. Let's see this. First is the basifixed anther, where the filament is attached to the base of the anther. Next one is the dorsifixed anther, where the filament is attached to the dorsal side of the anther. Next, coming for the next type of anther, that is the adenate anther, where the filament is attached all along the length of the anther lobes. Next is the versatile anther, which is a different type of anther where it is disc-like structure, and this disc-like structure is attached to a filament. And this is mainly seen in the anemophilous flower, where the pollination takes place with the help of wind. This anther, that is the versatile anther, releases the pollen, and this pollen is being carried by wind. Let's study the transverse section of anther. The anther consists of the single layer of fluxes, which are called as the epidermis. Beneath the epidermis, we have the radially arranged cells, and these radially arranged cells are called as the endothecium. These radially arranged cells are closely packed. These endothecium contains the callose thickening. Beneath the endothecium, we have the middle layer, which is made up of 3 to 4 layers of parenchyma cells. Epidermis, endothecium and middle layer together constitute the anther wall. And beneath the anther wall, we have the pollen sac. The young anther consists of the microsporangium, and the mature anther forms the pollen sac. Inside the microsporangium, we have a very important cell which is called as the tapetum. This tapetum is made up of the pyramid cells, which contains the dense cytoplasm, and it is multinucleated. Beneath the tapetum, we have the closely packed spiracle cells, and these spiracle cells are called as the archisporial cells. These archisporial cells further develops to give rise to the pollen grains. At the center, we have a strip of sterile tissue called as connective. This connective connects the two lobes of the anther. And this is a place where the dehiscence of the anther takes place. During the dehiscence of the anther, the three layers of the anther, that is the epidermis, the endothecium and the middle layer, becomes fibrous. This fibrous nature makes the layers rigid. And this portion of the anther remains unfibrous and it is immature, and hence which causes the dehiscence of the anther, which releases the pollen grains. Let's see the function of tapetum. Tapetum consists of the pyramidal cells. Each pyramidal cell consists of the dense cytoplasm and it is multinucleated. Let's see the four functions of tapetum. The first important function of tapetum is that it consists of the nutritive layer. This nutritive layer plays a very important role in nourishing and developing the microspore. Second important function of the tapetum is that it secretes the enzyme called as callase. We know that in endothecium we have callose thickening. Similar to this thickening, we have the callose in the microspore. This callose keeps together the tetrad pollen grain. This callase enzyme dissolves the callose to separate the tetrad pollen grains to give rise to four different pollen grains. The third important function of tapetum is that it produces a yuggish body which is called as the sporopollenin. The sporopollenin is the most resistant substance known till date. The sporopollenin forms the exine of pollen. It forms the exine of pollen. We will study this later. The fourth important function of tapetum is that it produces the pollen kit. We can see in some flowers of hibiscus that it produces the yellow powdery substance when we touch the anther. So this yellow substance is called as the pollen kit. Next we will see about the different types of tapetum. The first is the glandular tapetum, which is otherwise called as the secretory tapetum. The second type of tapetum is called as the amoeboid tapetum, which consists of the multinucleated cells and hence it is otherwise called as the plasmodial tapetum. In this video, we have studied about the transverse section of anther. In the next video, we will study about microsporogenesis. Until then, happy learning from Edu to all.